Mary was promised to marry a man named Joseph who lived there too.
One day an angel from God came and talked to Mary, and he said to her, "Greetings and favor, one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. In his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived, and this is the sixth month of her, who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
Now Joseph wasn't sure what to do when he had heard that Mary was going to have a baby. One night while he was asleep, the angel came to talk to Joseph too. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph awoke from his sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him to do.
Hopes and fears of all the years.
laid in his tent, which is the place where the animals take warm and dry.
While they were there, baby Jesus was born, and Mary took him and wrapped him up and laid him in the manger.
Praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them.
One day, after the baby Jesus had been born, wise men came to Jerusalem from the east looking for newly born King of the Jews.
So the king asked his advisors,
"But where is this King of the Jews to be born?"
"In Bethlehem."
"In Bethlehem, go and find him and let me know where he is, so I can come worship him too."
So the wise men went and found baby Jesus by following his star, and when they found him, they worshipped him.
But King Herod didn't really want to worship baby Jesus. He wanted to harm him. The wise men were warned by God about this, so they went home another way. King Herod found out he had been tricked. He was really mad.
He was determined to destroy his newborn king. So King Herod sent soldiers to Bethlehem to find baby Jesus.
But God warned Joseph in a dream to leave, and so they did. Joseph, Mary, and the little baby Jesus went to Egypt, and they stayed there until the evil King Herod had died.
After King Herod died, God told Joseph it was safe to come back. So Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus came back from Egypt to the little town of Nazareth.
Get all the kids back out here and take pictures if you want to come up to the stage real quick and get some.